everyone will be happy at their job. You will have high, you will have low turnover, high morale, people excited about learning because they feel like people generally care about me as an individual because they designed something for me so that I can be successful. So you're going to have people coming to work happy, people coming to work engaged, highly motivated, and people just wanting to do a great job because they feel that they are valued.
I think if everyone were upskilled on the LCD model, I think in the world of L&D, it would just completely revolutionize it because we are trained to think very linearly and from point A to point B, and that everyone needs the same thing. And the reality is that we live in a very diverse and different and creative world that people find their own solutions to things and they want to get there quickly. So the beauty, I think, of the LCD model is it meets you wherever you are. And then takes you on the journey that you need to get to the end. I like the fact that the LCD model really encourages people to learn the way they want to learn, when they want to learn, how they want to learn, and to a certain degree, what they want to learn. And I feel like my goal as an L&D professional is to create compelling learning assets that make people want to keep learning, even when their journey is technically done.
There can also be scenarios in which L&D is more like the order taker or someone who's kind of just coming in late in the development process. I think if more people were aware of the LCD model, I think it would just, again, elevate what we're doing and really show the value that learning professionals bring to companies and organizations because it is a really unique skill set. And there are so many really talented people in the field. And so I think bringing that professionalism to it and just the, a little bit of a more strategic perspective is really valuable.
I mean, obviously we would see an increase in training that is effective and that works. I think we would see probably less formal, like, you know, sitting in a classroom, which I think we can all agree there certainly is a time and place for that. But I think that focusing a lot more on social, which I learned through the workshop, you know, is a lot more effective than we give it credit for. People don't really think of that as learning, but it 100% is. So
if everyone adopted the model, I think what we would see would be a drastic improvement in where L&D is in the priority of how we dedicate time and resources in the workplace. Learning and development is something that we all do every day, and we need to do to continue to be competitive and to meet our business goals. And in order to do that, we need to be efficient and effective in doing that. And so what this model allows us to do is really bring it all together. And no matter if it's a very small skill that we need to hone or a very complex, this is a tool that is very easy to apply and can really support our organizations and elevate how we're supporting on-the-job behavior changes that tie back to business results. The LCD model and the book has become my Bible. I keep it next to my desk. It is a forever staple on my table, and I reference it constantly. And I think that as long as we continue to be open and, you know, asking ourselves those tough questions of what does the learner need? How does this tie to business results? Really probing in that strategy and then leveraging the components of this model, we can do really great things with L&D in the future.